ఇంటర్మీడియట్ విద్యా రంగంలో అగ్రగామి మన ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ ఐఐటి జేఈఈ అయినా నీట్ అయినా తిరుగులేని విద్యా సంస్థ ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్.
Hello students, we were discussing about the inflorescence. We are in the discussion about racemose inflorescence. So here let us discuss about the second category, racemose inflorescence. With the sessile flowers, racemose inflorescence with the sessile flowers. So here we have discussed about racemose inflorescence with the pedicellate flowers for the last class. What is the meaning of sessile here? Sessile here, it's nothing but a flower without pedicel. Flower without pedicel. Flower without pedicel is called as sessile flowers. Flower with pedicel, pedicellate flowers. Flower without pedicel, they are referred as sessile flowers. Now we are going to discuss the types of racemose inflorescence with sessile flowers. Now let us take the first one. That's nothing but spike. But before we discuss about the racemose inflorescence with the sessile flowers, but let me give the clarity because the people have chance to have a confusion here. Now when you take the racemose inflorescence, I'm just giving you the clarity here. When we take the racemose inflorescence, as we have discussed, we classify them into two categories. A racemose inflorescence with pedicellate flowers and other one is racemose inflorescence with sessile flowers. Now what do we take here? Now we are discussing the types. So what is the difference between these two types here? If you clearly observe, we need to find out the pedicel is here, but without pedicel here the flowers are sessile. When flowers with the pedicel, stalk is there, they are called pedicellate flowers. Flowers without stalk, they are called as what? Sessile flowers. Now let us talk about the types. In both categories, let us talk about the types. Now in this first one we called raceme. Now raceme we further classified into simple raceme and compound raceme. Then second one is referred as corym or also called as spike. But guys, here in racemose inflorescence with pedicellate flowers, let us take into consideration of corym, because spike is also the term which we applicable mostly for sessile flowers. Spike is also the term mostly applied for sessile flowers. So as we have written spike, spike can be written under the category of both pedicellate spike, or it can be written under the category called sessile spike. Okay, spike can be written either in pedicellate spike, or there we can write it as sessile spike. So here, to avoid confusion here, what you can write is, better you take down the corym. Spike, let us apply mostly in most of the books. Spike is applicable for sessile. Generally, pedicellate flowers also has spike, and sessile flowers also has sessile spike. But sessile terminology mostly applicable for sessile flowers. And some has pedicellate has a category called corym or spike. Right, now this is also further divided into a simple corym, and then we have a compound corym. Simple corym, and we have a compound corium. Then we have the umbel. Umbel is also further divided into two categories. We call a simple umbel and then a compound umbel. So here raceme has simple and compound. Corymb or spike has simple corymb or simple spike, you can write, no matter. And here also a compound corymb or you can write compound spike. But remember, mostly the terminology spike is applicable for sessile flowers. Umbel, then we have categories called simple umbel, compound umbel. So these three categories will come under racemose inflorescence with pedicellate flowers. So this we have discussed for the last class. Let us continue with a racemose inflorescence with sessile flowers. Now when we take the sessile flowers here, now let us talk about the types here. In this, the first type itself is called as a spike. So spike is referred as a simple spike and a compound spike. Generator, sir? On no unda, sir? Oh, sorry. Here is most inflorescence with the sessile flowers, and that the category spike is there. So that is simple and compound spike we make it. And second category is referred as catkin or amentum. Then, this part of this, if you take here, spathe, we have the category called as spathe. Or we call this one as spikelet. We call the third one as what? A spikelet. Then fourth one is referred as head inflorescence. So if we take here, even catkin is only one category what we have. Rest all again further divide into either third category we call spathe, spikelet, or which is also called as spadix. Simple spadix, compound spadix. So here now we are in the discussion about the sessile flowers. Now all together, if you take all four categories, they are further divided into spike, divided into simple and compound. Catkin and amentum, it's only one type, single type. A spathe, spikelet or spadix is again having simple and compound head inflorescence. Now we are going to discuss all the four categories which fall in the category called sessile. We already have completed the discussion about raceme, corymb and umbel for pedicellate flowers. This is completed, and now we are just in continuation of with what we call a sessile flowers. In sessile flowers, again we talk about spike. Don't confuse between the spike of pedicellate flowers and the spike of sessile flowers. So if you have confusion in your mind, better you replace the spike word with corymb. No problem. So corymb is for pedicellate spike and this spike is for sessile flowers, but mostly spike is applicable for sessile flowers only. Better you can take this spike, either you can write the spike of pedicellate flowers or you can write the spike is replaced by corymb. Mostly for pedicellate flowers we apply the term corymb, or it's also called spike, but mostly we apply corymb. Coming to this, we apply spike is a terminology for mostly for sessile flowers. So we are in the discussion about sessile flowers now. Let us discuss all four categories. So what is the very first one we have? It's nothing but what we call spike. Now spike is again further divided into two categories. The simple spike and then followed by the compound spike. Here in this case we should look at the simple spike has the characters same as like that of raceme. The spike has characters same as that of resin. So let us recollect it, what are the characteristics or the points we have discussed for resin. So here if you take, the first thing is related to peduncle. Peduncle, indefinite and grows indefinitely and it is unbranched. So as we discussed earlier, the basic categories like simple is nothing but unbranched and compound is nothing but what? Branched. That's the only difference. Rest of the characteristics will be of same. Now if you look at clearly under this, let us talk about the flowers. Same characteristics, bracteate. But in place of pedicellate, we write sessile flowers. What is meant by sessile flowers? Flowers without stalk, flowers without pedicel. Generally, they are referred as sessile flowers. Now, apart from this, even we say these are bisexual, and the arrangement of flowers is, even in this case, we find acropetal. When we say it is acropetal, obviously the opening of the flowers starts from where to where? So, F says here flower, opening of the flower is from base to apex. All characteristics, if you look at, they are listed, but here in place of pedicellate, we are writing, we find the compound called as, I find the category called as sessile flowers. Now, just look for the diagram, what we are going to draw. Now, this is the peduncle. On the peduncle, now if you look at the arrangement, a bigger flowers without stalk are at the base. Next, we find the arrangement like this. And the younger flowers we find on the top. So here you have to remember these flowers are nothing but sessile flowers. These flowers are nothing but what? Sessile flowers. So we are not drawing any stalk here, no pedicel here. Directly flowers are born laterally attached to the main axis on either side. On either side there are no stalk, no pedicels, flowers are laterally born on either side of the peduncle. Such type of arrangement are called as sessile flowers. Now the category we come under spike because here the flowers are sessile flowers. Very important thing here we need to remember about the examples. Examples are very very important. Look at the examples here. Acaranthus. Acaranthus is one example and acacia. Acacia and acaranthus are nothing but examples for simple spike. Now coming to the characteristics of the compound spike, same as it is we write, but in place of unbranched peduncle, in place of this for the compound we write peduncle is branched. And each branch of the peduncle looks like the simple spike. So here we write it is nothing but the branched one. Of course peduncle grows indefinitely. Same we write flowers is bracteate, sessile. Whenever we get a terminology or symbols called BR, BR refers to bracteate. Symbols, try to remember, BR refers to bracteate. What is the bracteate condition? We say flower with the bracts is called bracteate. Flower with bract is called bracteate. And they are sessile here. Now, apart from this, they are bisexual as usual and other conditions are same. Acropetal and moreover the opening is from base to apex. So in this compound spike here we take the example called as oryza. Oryza is nothing but the scientific name for rice. So let me write completely, oryza sativum. But here if you look at the characteristics comparison here, compound spike has entirely a different structure when compared with the simple spike. So what is the different structure we find for compound spike? Now let us discuss the structure here. Now let me draw the peduncle again with the arrangement of the flowers. Characteristics are common here, peduncle is same, flower condition is same, acropetal base to apex, but structurally it is highly differentiated when compared with the simple spike. Now let us make that compound spike itself is referred as the spikelet. In continuation of this, what we are discussing, the same compound spike, I'm writing it here. Now here we make it compound spike itself is referred as a spikelet. Excuse me. So the compound spike itself is referred as what? A spikelet. Now in this spikelet, when you look at the arrangement of this, now we can draw the main axis. The main axis in this case, it's called rachilla. Try to remember the terminology. Rachilla is the terminology which we applicable for compound spike, not for any other category. Rachilla is a terminology which we apply for peduncle in the case of compound spike, or we call a spikelet. Now why do you call this main axis? What is main axis here? We always say it's peduncle. Then why do you call the peduncle here as rachilla? It's because of the special arrangement structurally what you find in case of compound spike. Let us see the arrangement. Now in this rachilla we find the branch, right? In this rachilla we find the branch. Branch having a lower sterile bract. This is called as glume. Try to remember the terminology glume. What is a glume here? It's referred as a lower sterile bract without flavor. Without flavor. What do you refer here? Lower sterile bract. It's in the lowermost position here. Moreover, it is sterile without flavor. Sterile we call this because there is no flavor. Why do you call the terminology sterile here? Here there is no occurrence of flavor. Generally bract is present with the flower. Base of the flower, base of the pedicel, we find what is called bract. But in this case the bract does not contain the flavor. There is no flavor. That's the reason why we call this one as a sterile. So the lower sterile bract without flavor itself is called as glume. So what I've drawn here, it's a bract. It's a extended, elongated bract without flavor. It's referred as glume. Now slightly upper to this, what we find is called paleo. This is called as paleo, or we call lemma. So this is called as an upper bract with flavor. This is the upper bract. It surely encloses a flower. At the tip it surely contains the flower. That's the reason why it's called as lemma. So if you take this lemma, lemma is referred as an upper bract which contains the flower. Quite opposite to lemma, we find another structure of the bract which we call it as palea. It is referred it as what? Palea. Now look at the terminologies. Glume is at the base, exactly upper to this lemma. Opposite to lemma, what we find is called palea. Now try to come back to the part of understanding here. When you look at the glume, glume itself is a lower sterile bract without flavor. Upper to this we find the lemna. Lemma is nothing but upper bract with flavor. Quite opposite to lemma, the structure of the bract what we find is called as palea. Now in this you find two lodicules are there, then we find the arrangement of the flower. So this is the flower. So these are nothing but two lodicules, and this whole together, this is called as a flower. As two small spherical round structures which are present at the base of the flower are referred as lodicules. Generally remember they are referred as perianth. If you take your flower, what do you find? Calyx and corolla. Lower parts are called calyx and corolla. Inner to that, what we find is stamens and pistil. But in this flower, as it is reduced highly, so here calyx and corolla together fuse and they form two lodicules. Just remember, two lodicules are there, and that itself is called as perianth. All together, now you can see the flower. At the base of the flower, you find palea. Just opposite to palea, what we find is lemma. Lemma is called upper bract with the flower, and lower to this we find glume, and this is nothing but lower sterile bract without flower. Now, such kind of arrangement we find only in case of compound spike. That's the reason why it's called as a spikelet. Such type of arrangement we find only in case of compound spike. That's why it's called spikelet. That is the reason we call peduncle or the main axis as rachilla. This is different from rest types of inflorescence. So, we just have done the first one. We are in the discussion about racemose inflorescence with sessile flowers. First one is spike. Remember, acaranthus and acacia, you find this case. And compound spike we find in case of Oryza sativum. It's a scientific name for rice. Very, very important. Most commonly we discuss this example in most of the concepts. Right? So, what is the scientific name for rice? Keep remember in your mind, Oryza sativum. Now, coming to the characters, peduncle grows indefinitely. Here it is unbranched. That's why we call simple. Suppose the same thing you come for compound. Obviously, closing your eyes, you have to write peduncle is branched. Now, flowers are bracteate, sessile, bisexual. Arrangement is acropetal. Opening is from base to apex. Similarly, coming to compound spike, same conditions are there. Here we write sessile, same condition, but structurally entirely it is different from the rest of the inflorescence. That is the reason why you need to concentrate on the structure carefully here. Let's come from the base to tip or base to apex here. At the base we find glume. This is called lower sterile bract without flower. Slightly upper to this we find the structure. You have to remember it as lemma. That's upper bract with the flower. Quite opposite to this we find palea. In between all the bracts here, center we find the flower. Flower has two small circular structures. They are called lodicules. Lodicules are also nothing but here perianth. Perianth means it's nothing but fusion of both calyx and corolla. We will come to know about perianth. We will discuss a lot about perianth in the coming classes when we discuss about flower. Presently, you remember two small circular structures what we find in the flower at the base of the flower are called lodicules. They are two in number and moreover they are called perianth. Now, let's continue with the second concept, second category. What we call the second category, catkin or amentum. Racemose inflorescence with the sessile flowers, under the second category we are discussing catkin or amentum. Now, in this, it is not further classified into simple and compound, it is only one type because it is a rare and found only in few members. Right. Now, a catkin or amentum, it is nothing but what we find, peduncle is no doubt unbranched because it is only one category and long pendulous. What's the meaning of pendulous we are writing? Here it says that it shows the free hanging in the surface. Moreover, it contains unisexual flowers. So here I am writing three star marks, very very important. Why the three star marks represents here? You need to stress the point here, you need to remember. Why? Because so far all the categories whatever we have discussed, if you carefully observe, in most of them we write bisexual flowers. But coming to catkin or amentum, in this case we write unisexual flowers. Very 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 important. So catkin or amentum means very important point what you need to remember here. Here there is an arrangement of unisexual flowers. So for example, here remember the example, morus. Morus is commonly called as mulberry. Morus is commonly called as mulberry. Now in this case we find this is a branch. Branch has the pedicel here. Now you find the structure will be like this. This kind of inflorescence with the arrangement of unisexual flowers, this itself is called catkin or amentum. What you can see here, this is nothing but the inflorescence. Now this is having long and this is a branched here, this is unbranched here, and pendulous. Pendulous means free moving in the air, very long in nature. Moreover, it contains the arrangement of unisexual flowers. So you know, morus is nothing but what is, you have to remember as an example, morus, commonly it is referred as mulberry. The arrangement of unisexual flowers in the pendulous unbranched peduncle itself is called as catkin or amentum. Now let us go with the third category, spadix. Spadix has again divided into simple spadix and compound spadix. So let us go with the division of study of both characteristics. The spadix is further divided into two categories. Let us clearly differentiate a simple spadix with the study of the compound spadix. Now in case of simple spadix, you can see that this is nothing but spathe. Now here we find appendix at the center. It has an arrangement of flowers at the base and in the middle like this. Try to differentiate the arrangement of flowers. Now look at here. Now in this case here, very important thing is bract is modified into a thick sheet. The thick sheet what is present here itself is called as spathe. So I'm drawing here the spathe here. It's nothing but outermost thick sheet which encloses the inflorescence. So this spathe encloses the total inflorescence. This spathe encloses the total inflorescence. Now the best example to understand the diagram or the structure what I have drawn on the board, the best example is Musa paradisica. What is Musa paradisica? It's nothing but the scientific name for banana. Now when you see the banana plant, you can see the formation of violet color bud. This much violet color big bud will come, and if you open the bud, what you find the violet color structure is nothing but the thicker layer that itself is called spathe. So I'm discussing about the Musa. Musa is nothing but what? Banana. Now the young fruits which are produced here, all the bananas, the younger stage of the smaller bananas are enclosed within the a protective layer that itself is called spathe. I think you might have observed in banana plant, In Musa banana plant, the outermost thick purple color or violet color structure itself is called spathe. Similarly, we find here the bract is the one which get modified totally into a formation of the thicker one, a thick layer, the thick sheath here, and this itself is called as spathe. Inside the spathe you can see arrangement of inflorescence, meaning spathe encloses the inflorescence. Now, how the inflorescence is arranged here? Now, this is called as the peduncle. Peduncle is called as appendix. What is this appendix here? It's called as peduncle. Inside, this is spathe. This layer it's called spathe. Let us better make it a very thick layer here. Let us share it here. Make it thick. That says that it's a thick layer. And remember, it's called as spathe. So this is a protective layer. So all over the inflorescence, inflorescence is covered by completely spathe. Now inside we find the peduncle. Peduncle itself is called as appendix. On the appendix we find the arrangement of flowers. What the flowers we find here? Now here you find male flowers. The symbol is for male here. This is called male flowers. Male flowers are arranged at the apex. Now neuter flowers. Neuter flowers are arranged exactly in the center. What are neuter flowers here? Neuter flowers are without stamens and carpels. There are no stamens and there are no carpels. So in this case you can see without stamens and carpels, only the calyx and corolla, meaning only the petals are there, but inside no stamens and no carpels. Such type of flowers are generally referred as neuter flowers. Where is the location of neuter flowers? Exactly in the center. Now look at the base. Now at the base we find the arrangement of female flowers. So symbol what I have written here, that represents female. So here this is nothing but arrangement of female flowers, where they are arranged exactly at the base. This is very important, you have to remember, because the structure is found only in case of simple spadix. Let me repeat. Now the bract is modified into a thick sheath. What you can see in a blue color dark one here, this is called as a bract. Bract is modified into a structure called thick sheath called spathe. Now spathe, it protects and encloses complete inflorescence. Now inside the spathe what we find is called peduncle. On the peduncle we find arrangement of flowers. Now this peduncle itself is called as what? Appendix. Now on the peduncle you can see arrangement of flowers. Now you can see male flowers are arranged at the apex. These all are male flowers. Try to differentiate structure wise, you just make it a different structure, because male flower structure is different, a neuter flower structure is different, and female flower structure is different. Slight difference you can make it at the time of drawing. So at the what you have to remember, male flowers are present at the tip or apex. Exactly in the center you find arrangement of neuter flowers. Why do we call them as neuter flowers? It's because remember they are without stamens and carpels, without male and without female flowers. Now exactly at the base we find a female flower. Such type of arrangement we find in case of simple spadix. And let me keep so many star marks here, very very important. Why it is very important here? Not only the structure, the examples are very very important. Most frequently the questions arises from simple spadix. Now let us come to the examples. Just I'm writing here the examples. All examples are very very important. Now questions mostly they come from simple spadix. What could be the questions? Sometimes they ask you, where do we find the largest spadix inflorescence? So let me write the question here. Largest spadix inflorescence. So the largest spadix inflorescence which we find in case of Amorphophallus and Colocasia. Whenever the question is, where do we find the largest spadix inflorescence, then look for the options Amorphophallus and Colocasia. Guys, if you remember, we discussed something else which is also very important earlier classes in about Amorphophallus and Colocasia. Could you recollect what we have discussed about Amorphophallus and Colocasia? Where do we discuss that part exactly? In stem modifications. Where in stem modifications? We discussed in underground stem modifications. What type of underground stem modifications we have discussed? So we have four categories: rhizome, comb, bulb and tuber. So under comb we discussed about Amorphophallus and Colocasia. There also there we studied very important note points, means question getting points. What are they? Largest apical bud is present in Zaminkand, Amorphophallus, Colocasia. Did you remember? Largest apical bud the question is given, or if the question is largest spadix inflorescence, and you have to look for options Amorphophallus and Colocasia. Very, very, very important. What are the questions you have to remember? Largest apical bud is found in. Look for Amorphophallus. Sometimes Amorphophallus may not be given in the options. Zaminkand, that is a common name. Even that was not there in the options, then no need to worry, because second largest one you find in case of Colocasia. Suppose if the question is largest spadix inflorescence, again look for Amorphophallus and Colocasia. And suppose another question, let me give you the questions here. Right, another question is largest is this, then where do we find smallest? So let me give you the smallest spadix inflorescence. It's present in the smallest plant, that is called lemna. It's referred as lemna. Very, very important. I repeat, very, you need to note down. These are note points you need to note down. What are the important, two important questions which we get from spadix inflorescence? Largest spadix inflorescence we find in Amorphophallus, Colocasia, and the smallest spadix inflorescence we find in case of lemna. See, you need to look for the place where I keep three star marks. The three star marks are nothing but question getting points. You need to stress over there and you need to practice and remember the examples along with the concept. This is very, very, very important. Q is nothing but question getting point, or you can take it as a note point. Very, very important. Now, coming to compound spadix, we find same characteristics. But here, if you look at the spathe, or we say it's nothing but hard, woody, and moreover boat shaped. Compound spadix will be very hard and very thick and woody, and it will be in boat shape. Take down the example. This is very commonly we know. It's nothing but Coccus nucifera. Where do we find Coccus nucifera? That's nothing but coconut. Coccus nucifera is nothing but the scientific name for coconut. Remember, wherever we talk about scientific names are very, very important, you need to remember along with the common name. So coconut is generally, if you observe the coconut plant, what you find at the tip of the main axis of the main peduncle, you know, very thick and very woody one, and mostly it looks like a boat shaped one. That itself is a representation of compound spadix. Inside we find same arrangement, spathe will be there, female flowers will be there, neutral flowers will be there, and at the tip we find male flowers. Right, such type of arrangement itself we call it as what? Compound spadix. Very, very important. It was a previous NEET question. Guys, just make a note of it. This question has appeared nearly two times. If you take the last 10 years question papers, if you take nearly two to three times the question appeared on the paper. That is, mostly they ask for what is the example for the compound spadix, or indirectly they ask the question that where do we find the hard, woody, boat shaped spadix inflorescence or spathe. It's nothing but, you remember, Coccus nucifera, coconut. So if you see in coconut plant, we generally say kobbari matta, right? That in Telugu we call kobbari matta. That itself is nothing but, in our science we call that as the compound spadix. Very, very important. It was a previous NEET question. So keep so many star marks here. That indicates it's also important. Altogether, what you have understood, spadix is the most important part for all of us to refer and remember along with the structure, including the very important examples.